96% of people like cheesy opening jokes, according to a survey of DNews writers. Hey there, voters. Trace here for DNews. In this election year, with so much stock being put into what the polls say, it's important that they are accurate as possible. But depending on the poll, the results could be a reflection of how the nation feels as a whole, or a bunch of fringe supporters skewing the outcomes. What's the science behind designing a poll that will accurately predict how the country will vote? Obviously, no poll can get a hold of everyone in the country, otherwise our phones would be ringing constantly. Instead, pollsters have to interview a relatively small number of people and extrapolate their data from there. They call this a sample, or N. Scientific polling organizations will aim to survey 1,000 to 1,500 people. Statistically, the result will almost always have a 3% margin of sampling error then, meaning that these people should be representative of the population's attitude, give or take 3%. They could survey more people, but after 1,000 people, the margin of error doesn't really decrease much. To get the margin of error down to 1%, pollsters would have to survey 10,000 people. At that point, it's not really worth the time or effort, not to mention the money. There are other kinds of errors that go unaccounted for, like errors in analysis, where certain assumptions the researchers make about how to handle their data could turn out to be wrong, and the non-response error, where people who support a candidate who's behind are less likely to respond, further skewing overall results. Polling organizations, like the Pew Research Center, for example, will find participants by calling them, selecting the geographical area by area code and then the next 5 digits of a phone number. Then they will randomly dial the last 2 digits. The phone numbers randomly selected from one area are supposed to be proportional to that area's share of phone numbers in the country. The idea is to get totally random representatives from across the nation on the phone, though with more people switching to cell phones, it's gotten a bit harder to pin people down. Getting them on the phone is the first step, but the researchers know they don't have an accurate sample just yet. Older people are more likely to answer a landline, so the Pew Research Center will ask for the youngest male in the house half the time and the youngest female in the house the other half. If it's a cell phone, yes, pollsters can and do call cell phones, they just make sure that the person is over 18. When it comes to election polling, they'll also ask if the person they're surveying plans to vote. If you don't plan to vote, your opinion doesn't really matter, at least to the outcome of the election. Then they'll ask who they plan to vote for. It's important this question comes first, and that the order the candidates are listed is switched up. Asking about policy questions first can make a participant realize they don't actually agree with a candidate. Constantly listing one candidate first can also impact the survey, especially in primaries where there can be several candidates and it's hard to keep track of them over the phone. All these precautions are things online polls don't do. Their samples consist of just the website's readership, which could skew to one area, one age group, one political bias, or people who won't even vote. News organizations love to say, our online poll shows, but their online poll isn't a representative sample and doesn't actually show anything except what the people who come to their website might think. Sometimes political ads even masquerade as polls, asking questions about a candidate in a negative way to sway opinion. Because scientific polls strive to eliminate as many of these confounding factors as possible, they are much more reliable than online public surveys. If you want to check out how well they perform, the National Council on Public Polls keeps track of how accurate each poll was after every election. You can check out their link in the description below. In 2012, Pew predicted Obama would win 50% to 47%, and the final tally, 51 to 47. We think we're pretty special with our precious democracy, but it isn't uniquely human. Julian and I explore other species that vote here. The researchers tracked the movements of a troop of olive baboons in Kenya and found that every member of the troop had an equal say in where they all went.
Now, this was surprising because olive baboons have a strong social hierarchy, and dominant members get choice picks of food or mates over their subordinates.
So even though open online polls are essentially meaningless, they promote audience engagement. Do you think a poll is the best way to do that, or is there a smarter way to get people involved? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.